Hi guys, good morning. Welcome back to CID. Today we're going to learn how can we make a simple website with using Flask. So I hope you have installed Flask in your system. If you have not, then I will show you how can you install. Here we'll use Flask as the framework in Python. So I hope you have at least Python, and we'll use Flask for making website. And also we'll use HTML files and Bootstrap. So I hope you have some basic knowledge about these things. So let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to desktop and creating a folder, and I will name it to my first Flask app. Okay, now open this folder. And copy its address, open command prompt with admin privilege and go to that folder. And now we are in this folder. Now we have to make a virtual environment. I am working with virtual environment. You can do with directly in your Python, but for a good practice we recommend to use virtual environment. So we'll create virtual environment with calling python slash m venv, and I'm naming the virtual environment as env. Okay, hit enter, and now it will make a folder called env in our current folder, as you can see. Now it has created. Now time to activate this virtual environment. So we'll call env, that means the folder name, and in this you will get script folder, and under that we'll get activate name. So we'll call it. Now it will be activated. As you can see, it is showing out here env, that means it is activated. Now time to install some dependencies. We'll use Flask for making this website. So we'll type here pip install Flask, and it will install Flask in our virtual environment. Now it has successfully installed. So let's go to our folder, and here we'll make a Python file. So open your PyCharm or any type of IDEs. I'm using Python IDLE here because it is too faster than others. So I'm using IDLE. You can use IDE. And here we'll make a Python file. So I'm going to create a new file here, and I will save it in our current directory. So go to desktop. And here we'll go to my first Flask app and create a file called app. So it is saved in our current directory. And now time to import Flask. So we'll use from Flask import Flask. Here Flask is with capital F, and here Flask is with small f. Okay, so be sure. And now we'll have to get the instance of Flask class. So we'll use Flask, and here we'll inherit, we'll give the name attribute here, and now we'll have to execute this. So we'll type And now we'll get the run method of Flask with object app. So we'll call app.run, and under the parenthesis of this we'll pass debug equals true. Debug equals true means when we'll make some changes in our app, then it will be directly refreshed and our server will be restarted again. So we have made Flask app here, and now we'll have to make some roads. You can imagine a website in which there was a home page and some other pages. So these are called roots in Flask. So we'll make some roots here, and we can make root with calling app.route, okay, and under the parenthesis we'll pass the route, okay. So as the string we'll pass here slash, so that means it will be home page, and here we'll make method for this route. So we'll make this as home, okay, and under home we are going to just return hello new programmer, okay. So it will be returned in our web browser, and it will show the home page here with just these three strings, okay. So let me save it and we'll run this. So how can we run this? Let me go to my cmd and we'll type just python app.py, okay. App.py is our main file, okay. So we'll hit enter, then it will be started. As you can see, it is going out, restarting with stat, and it will show the server. So this is our server on which our web will be available. So let me go to our browser, and now under the browser we'll have to go to this web address and hit enter. Now as you can see, it is showing out hello new programmer. So now make another route, okay. So I will copy it and paste it again, and it will be about page, okay. Suppose it will be about page, so we'll make the route as about. It is slash about, okay, not only about, it is slash about. So this your here, and I'm typing here about page, okay. Now save, and you will see that it will show again restarting with the stack, because we have debug equal to true, so it is automatically restarting, and some problems are available here. Let me see what is the mistake here. Okay, same methods are available here, so I will use about method, and now save it. And now you will see that when we'll run this app and we'll go to our browser, then go to about. So we'll type here slash about and we'll hit enter, then it will show hello new programmer in about page, okay. So both these pages are working, okay. We can also make many type of routes for same method with calling the same things here and passing another route as home, okay. That means when you will go to this address and this address, same method will be called. So let me save it and show you with going at home. You will see that it is showing out here, and let me do again with this, then you will see that it is again here, okay. So we have the routes here, but we are not making some HTML files here, we are just returning some string. So have to make the HTML files. So for this we'll have to use another thing from Flask, that is render template, okay. Render template, okay. So for this we'll have to make another directory. So we'll go to our directory and we'll create another folder and we'll name it to templates, okay. Be sure about this spelling, you can do mistakes in spelling of that, it is in a small case, and it is templates, okay, but not template. Okay, now time to make some HTML files. So open any type of your favorite text editors. I have Notepad Plus here and I will make this. So I'm going to save this in our current directory, and on desktop we have a folder here called my first Flask app. So let me go to it and under templates, and here we'll type home.html. okay, and now do it as all types. Now save it. Now we have home.html here, and now we can use Bootstrap here. So let me go and directly use Bootstrap. You don't have to type anything in your HTML file, just go to Bootstrap, and we'll use Bootstrap for making our website. So open Bootstrap website. Okay, we have here Bootstrap website. So let me go to getbootstrap.com, and under this we'll go to get started. So click on get started and copy the starter template. So let me go down here, and you will see that here is starter template code. You can see these are the things, and we can copy it. So just go here and copy it. Okay, so it says copy it. And now let me go to our home.html file and paste it here. Sorry, it has not copied. Again, let me copy it and paste it here. So it has copied and pasted here. So let me save, and here title is Hello World. So let me change the title as home. Okay, and now here is h1 tag, so we can change it to hello from home page. Okay, now let me save it, and now go to your app.py file, and here under the home method we will return render template, and under the parenthesis we'll pass as the string our HTML file. So we'll call home.html. okay, so it will return home.html. so let me go again with saving it. It is being restarted, so wait for a moment, and it has restarted. Now let me refresh again, and you will see that here is the title and it is showing out hello from home page. So it is working. Now we can make the same for about. So go to templates and copy it and paste it again, and rename it to about page, and open this about.html in your text editor. Now change here with about title, and also here from about page. Okay, sorry, about page, and let me set it. Okay, now let me go to app.py and do the same thing for about page too. So we'll copy it and paste it here, and we'll change it to about. So it is now about.html, and let me save, and now it is restarting again. And now we can go to our about page, and now you will see that it is showing out hello from about page. That means both things are working. Now we can make some styles here. Suppose we have the codes for about.html. let me enlarge it. We have about.html and also home.html, but the codes for about and home page are similar. Okay, so we have some things to do in Flask so that our code will be just readable but not headache for about home or will make many other files. So we can inherit one file in others just like extending that. So we can use Jinjer template for this. So let me go and show you how can we make. Let me paste another thing here. Let me copy and paste it again, and we'll rename this file as layout. Okay, layout.html, and we can go here and open this layout.html in your text editor. And now tap to remove all the things from about.html and also from home.html. okay, and now go to layout, and here under layout.html we have title. Okay, so suppose title will be for home.html as home, and about.html that means about will be for about.html, and for other pages that will be another. So we can use here Jinjer template, and we can use Jinjer template like this. We have curly brace open and closed, and here under percentage we'll type here like this block, and we'll name it as title. Okay, so we have block title here, and remove this home and type here to in this block. So we'll type under the percentage end block. So we have made a block for Jinjer template, and we can make the titles here. So we can copy it and paste it in about.html, but we'll have to firstly extend the layout.html in about.html. so we can use Jinjer template here like this, extends, and under extends we'll pass as the string layout.html. so layout.html is extended here, and we can paste now the title, and we can pass here the title for this, and we are in about.html, so we will pass here about. Okay, now we can go to the home.html. so we can copy it and paste it in home.html, and it will be extended here too, but here title will be like home. Okay, now go to layout.html, and here we have h1 tag, so we can remove this h1 tag from here. And now under the body tag we can use another Jinjer template block, and under this we'll type block, and I'm naming it as content. Okay, now we have to end this block, so we'll type end block. So it has ended the block, and now under this block we can write the things. So we can go to about.html. okay, so let me copy, and now under this we'll go to block content, and under this block content we can type the things which are only for about.html but not the other pages. Okay, so suppose we have here h1 tag, and under this h1 tag we are just writing the things like you are in about page. Okay, and now let me close this h1 tag. Okay, now we are in about page with writing this. Let me copy it in home.html, and now under the block content we are typing you are in home page. Okay, that's it. Now let me save it. All the files are being saved here, and now go and refresh the thing. So now as you can see that it is showing out you are in about page. Let me go to home page, so it will show you are in home page. Now we have done the basic thing. Now let me design. So we can go to Bootstrap, and under the component we'll firstly use navbar. As you can see here, it is the navbar for Bootstrap. So we can go down below and select a navbar. So we have a navbar here. Now click. Now under this you will get a navbar here, so we can copy it. And now go to your layout.html, because when we are extending this layout.html in all the files, so under the body tag we'll just paste it here. Okay, now we have a navbar here, and let me do a comment here so that you will be notice that from where navbar is. And now we can close the navbar and add the block comment as navbar in. Okay, so we are in navbar, and let me save it. Go to our page and refresh. Now you will see that it is showing out a navbar here. So let me make some changes in this navbar. So we'll go to layout.html, and firstly we'll change the name of navbar with our website name. Suppose my website name is my first app. Okay, so we'll change it to my first app. And now we are in home page here, and also we are in link, so we can change it to about. And now make some changes with drop down. We can change the drop down as, suppose under this we are in students, and suppose it is teacher section and something else. Okay, now let me save it and refresh it. Now you will see that it is showing on the thing, but after clicking on home and about it is not working. Okay, so we can add the things here, and we'll add this with Jinja template. So we'll just go here in our app.py, and we'll import another thing that is called url4. okay, now let me save it and go to layout.html, and here under this we'll pass like thing url4. So we'll use double curly brace open and close, and we'll type here url_4, and url_4, and under the parenthesis of this we'll pass the method name. Okay, we have method name as home, and let me copy it for about also. So paste it here, and we'll type here about. Okay, so now we have linked home and about in this nav links. So we can save it, and now refresh it again. Now click on about, so it is working, and also going to home, it is working. Now make some changes in our navbar. So let me go to navbar, and here we have background light, so we can change it to background primary. It is blue color, and navbar is also light, so we can make it as dark. Okay, now save it and go and see what is working. Okay, it is working fine, and you will see that it is a nice navbar. Okay, now we can add some more things here, and I will show you how can we make a coil. Okay, how can we use a coil here? You can add many type of things here. As you can see, many type of components from Bootstrap is available here, and these are for free, so you can use. So we can use the width control coil. So let me copy this coil. Now it is copied, and now I want to add this coil after block content. So we'll go to after block content, and let me add a comment here, and I will type here slide images. Okay, and down below another comment, slide finished. Okay, now under this comments, let me paste it. So we have pasted, and now under this image SRCs, we can add some images. You can add your own images, but I'm going to use from web page. Okay, so we'll use some computer images here. So we'll search for computer images. And now click on any image and get the address of that. So I'm going to open this image and click on that. And now it is the address of this. And I'll recommend that do not use in your website. If you are unknown to the copyright of these images, I'm doing these things for only teaching purpose. So let me go on our layout.html, and under image src I will paste this address. And now under another, I'm doing the same. Okay, you can change the image here, but I'm doing the same for all the image sources. Okay, now we have done, and let me save it. Now we can go to home page and now refresh. Now you will see that it has a slide here, and slide is also working. We can resize it, and you will see that it is showing out the slide very clearly. Okay, we can add some more things. I'll just use footer here. So let me show you how can we add a footer here. So under layout.html, we'll go after slide, and we'll add here a footer. So I'll make here a div. Okay, and under div I'm using some classes, div class equal to, I'm using some classes here, and first class is I'm using text center. I want the text as center, so I will use the class text center, and these classes are defined in Bootstrap. Okay, so now it is text center, and using the background as blue color, so I'll use background primary, and also we'll use text, and text color I will use as white. Okay, now we have the div here, and now under the div I'm going to use the footer tag I'm using. Okay, and under this footer I'm going to use like this. This app is copyright, and let me use the copyright symbol. So we'll use and copy and to CID. Okay, now it is now a footer. Now let me save and go again in our browser, and you will see that it is showing out this app is copyright to CID, and here it is also working. Okay, so we have done. You can add some more things with going to Bootstrap, and you can add many things here. Okay, so I hope guys you have enjoyed this tutorial. If you are new to this channel, then please do subscribe and press the bell icon for new updates. Thanks for watching.